So a couple of weeks back, Akshan and I were sitting, I think it was a Thursday before my dance class, and we were thinking about what's next. What is the topic that we can explore and put up on Manova? And I instinctively said, what do you think about makeup, Akshan? And he was like, sounds good, maybe, maybe not. And we were kind of indecisive. I was kind of excited, but still we were like, okay, let's see where we go with this. And Akshan goes like, you know, why are we deciding this amongst ourselves? We should just ask the world what they want. Let's ask the people. And so next thing we know, we're sending out this mass emailer, this mass WhatsApp message to our audiences, asking, what do you want to learn next on Manova? And once the results came in, guess what it was? It was makeup. And so the people had spoken, and that's it, it was decided. So we went over to Anjan's house. Anjan is a really close friend. She is a beauty editor, has worked previously at Vogue and at Elle. So she basically lives and breathes makeup. We went over to her house and we're like, okay, Anjan, you know what? We want to do makeup next. Who do you think we should get on board as our instructor and mentor? And I kid you not, she did not even take 1 second to reply back to my question. And she was like, I know just the person you have to work with. She is at the top of her game, and I swear there's nobody better than her out there. And her beauty philosophy is amazing. And I was like, okay, who is this person? And she's like, it's Aarti, Aarti Nair. And I was like, okay, so what's next? And she's like, I'm gonna get a meeting set up. Let's chat with her, and I really hope this works out. And so I was like, all right, let's do it. And so skip forward a couple of months, and I'm so, so, so excited to present Aarti Nair as our instructor and mentor for our makeup lab. Thank you so much. Hello, hello. I'm so excited to have you here.
Thank you for having me.
The past, yes, yes, it's been such a pleasure working with you. Aarti, you're a talent powerhouse and a makeup connoisseur, and you've been around for so, so long. You've painted the faces of Bollywood's leading ladies like Sonam Kapoor, Katrina Kaif, Sara Ali Khan, but I'm sure it wasn't always like this. So tell me, where did you begin? How did you get here? What has the journey been like?
It's been a great journey. It's been super exciting, a lot of hard work, but I think it started many years ago, and a lot of you have heard me say this, but it started many years ago because I was obsessed with Hindi cinema and I was obsessed with all of that. And as soon as I finished college, I knew exactly what I wanted to do in terms of like be in the business of films and all of that. And I didn't know where to go, I didn't know where to put my foot and what to do. And one day I was going through a magazine and we were all sitting, and you know, suddenly I thought of it and I was like, you know, why don't I do a beauty course? Why don't I at least learn the basics and the techniques? So I did a course with Bharat and Doris for like 3 months. They had just finished Om Shanti Om, so you know, it was super exciting for me.
Yeah.
And after that, again, I didn't know what to do because I didn't know anyone in the film industry. I didn't know. So it was like, again, like how you guys sent like this mass email to everybody. I just told everyone. And I think in St. Xavier's, where I did my, where I went to college, there's so many people in the media field, in films and, you know, things like that. So I took a chance and I told everyone. I said, you know, I'm willing to do anything, whatever job it might be. I just want to get my foot into the door and then I'll figure it out.
Oh my God, you know? the best attitude, basically.
Yeah, it's the best attitude to have. And I think, I just didn't look left or right. I did my course. I learned all the techniques and all the basics of the foundation that I needed to learn. And one fine day, long story short, I get a call from someone's friend who needed an assistant. And they were like, you know, it's not makeup, but do you want to do it? And I was like, yes. Like it was a no-brainer. I had to do it, and it was, you know, an assistant stylist position. And I was like, you know what, I'm going to make the best of this situation. And I think that is something that I learned very early on in my career, that it doesn't matter whether the opportunity is big or small, it's the fact that you get it.
When and the then, door opens for you, you've got to go.
Yeah, and what you do with that opportunity is then up to you. You know, do you want to work hard and see where that goes? Or do you want to just like pass it on and, you know, not pay heed to it? So I think that's up to you, and what you do with that, like I said, is also up to you. So I took that opportunity and I was like, you know what, I'm going to do this job to the best of my ability. Mm-hmm. I'm going to get to know people, I'm going to build my contacts, and I'm going to see where that goes. I didn't know where it was going to lead. I just knew that in that moment, this is what I had to do.
That's amazing.
And that's the same philosophy I tell a lot of upcoming makeup artists in the industry, makeup enthusiasts. If you want to be a part of this journey, I think you just have to be patient and you have to recognize opportunity and then make the best of it.
Mm-hmm. So you got into styling.
Yeah.
So in my head, if somebody gets into styling, they like keep going on the straight path and go like deeper into styling. So how did makeup happen? Where did that
come
from?
You know, when you're a stylist, I mean, you know, the process of getting into character, like for any movie, or even if it's like an event look, there are lots of people involved. So the stylist will speak to the makeup artist and everyone has to, you know, be on the same page and work towards the same look,
mm-hmm.
like we say. So when I was a stylist, I was also a very integral part of the entire process of the look. So what is the hair going to be like? What is the makeup going to be like? And when I would sit in these meetings, I would of course be drawn to what the makeup was like because that's what I learned, that's what I wanted to do. Styling was just a stepping stone in that direction,
mm-hmm.
you know? And I mean, I love clothes, you know, I love that job that I did it for like 3-4 years. I loved it. But I always knew that I was drawn to makeup. But, you know, all those years ago, and I'm talking like 12 years ago, there was not so much social media. You couldn't just like, you know, go on the internet and kind of look up your favorite artist, message them and be like, can I assist you? You know, like it happens to us a lot right now. Then you had magazines. You had to go in the magazine, look up the names, see who you would like. And with all my research, I knew that I really, really wanted to work with Namrata.
Mm-hmm.
Namrata Soni, and her makeup was far ahead of her time. It was so much more modern. It was almost like setting a new trend, you know, and I knew that I wanted to work with her. So in my head, I promised myself that, you know, through styling, like you get to meet so many makeup artists, you do so many shoots, and I knew that I will meet her and I will figure it out. And I just kept telling myself that I think I kind of manifested it in some way.
Wow, yeah.
And then when I started working on Aisha and I was so busy in like so many clothes and trying to figure out all the outfits for the girls, one day she walked in for a meeting because she was going to be Sonam's makeup artist. And at that moment, I kind of knew, like it was crazy in my head right now. At that point, I was like awestruck. But now when I look back at it, I was like, you know, this is the moment you've been waiting for all your life. I keep talking about it also that I knew I could see the opportunity that I had and I did not
let it go.
I just didn't let it go.
You attacked it. Basically.
I attacked it.
Okay, tell me something. So what was it about makeup that drew you in so much? Because the world of clothes is equally amazing.
I love clothes. I mean, all of us do. But you know, there's something about makeup that what actually drew me to makeup was that I think I was on the cusp of, like, you know, the entire world was looking at makeup differently. You know, we were going into that space of like less is more,
mm-hmm.
You know, which was also personally my beauty philosophy. Like, I've always like believed in it, and I always believed that, you know, your natural skin should show through and you should love the skin that you're in and all of that. But I also could see that that was changing in the world of, in the beauty industry, as
mm-hmm.
they say. And the way even we were approaching makeup in films, the kind of lighting that was coming on, the kind of camera work that was coming on, everything was just changing so beautifully that you had to adapt. We were all learning new ways of, you know, doing makeup.
Yeah.
And we were all going in that direction, you know, as artists, as trendsetters, or so as they say, we were all going in that direction. We wanted less is more. We wanted to look more natural. Even
not
like
plaster.
Yeah, you know, not like how we used to do makeup all those years ago in cinema. If you see older films,
mm-hmm.
it's very different to the kind of makeup we're doing now. And, you know, so it was really, that is actually what drew me, because I wanted to be part of that change. I wanted to be part of that time when, you know, you're kind of bringing on that change in makeup, where you're saying, you know, guys, less is more. we don't have to like, you know, layer it and, you know, and that is what drew me to it, like where the stroke of one pencil or just using two products, you can completely change your look, you know, just enhance few features. You don't have to go all out all the time.
Was there like a kind of template of beauty or of like how a face should look before? And then do you think that's kind of changed where people are embracing more of how they should, how they actually do look now?
You know, I think earlier, again, you know, there was not so much this makeup artist kind of role. Like when we started, when I started, and I remember telling my parents I wanted to be a makeup artist. Makeup artist was not really a job. You know, it was not really something that was a career choice for you. Now, like 12 years or almost 14 years forward, it's a proper career. Like, you know, I am a makeup artist, you know, and it's nice to see that, you know, it's nice to see that change. It's nice to see that, you know, our approach to makeup, I mean, is also so much, it's grown so much over the years, you know, whereas earlier it used to be, yeah, you know, you're doing makeup for like for film. It was not so much about your daily life or, you know, how you would do makeup for like how we're sitting right
now.
Yeah,
of course, yeah.
But also again, I wanted to be part of that change, you know, to kind of bring on that, even with the influence of like social media and internet and being like all perfect and everything needs to look prim, proper.
Yeah.
You can't forget your roots. You can't forget the fact that not all of us have it all together.
All the time, of course.
All the time. So you have to love the skin that you're in. You have good days, you have bad days. It happens to us, it happens to celebrities, it happens to everyone. You know?
It's part of being human. Yeah.
Exactly.
And I love how you've reflected that same exact philosophy in the makeup lab while you're going through all of the episodes. So do you want to talk a little bit about that?
I do. I think it was very important to kind of not forget that part. You know, even when we were doing putting together these labs and we were, you know, thinking about what we wanted to do and how we wanted to bring out all of these different, you know, let's say problems people have with makeup or questions you have about makeup. I think you can never forget the basic philosophy that I didn't want to forget the basic philosophy that I have about makeup.
Yeah.
You know, I don't want to tell people that you know, you need to layer it, you need to put corrector, concealer, foundation every single day, you need a prim, proper. No, there are days when your hair is just going to be flat, no matter how much shampoo you, I mean, no matter how much dry shampoo you put, no matter how hairspray you put, it's going to look flat and it's okay. You know, no matter how much you try to hide that pigmentation, that one particular day, it's just not going to get hidden, you know. But it's fine because I feel like you need to embrace that and it's not going to stay forever, right? It's one odd day, it's two odd days, three odd days. And I never want to be that sort of an artist that forgets that very foundation of makeup. That, you know, you have to, first of all, that less is more. You know, you don't have to go all out. You don't have to buy all the makeup in the world.
Yeah.
Yes, if you have access to that makeup, great. It's like when I started my career, I didn't have enough money to buy expensive products. And, you know, I couldn't afford it. I couldn't even afford to go to school. You know, abroad, I had to learn what I had with me, and I think that assisting Namrata was like going to school.
Yeah,
you know, that
is that transformational for you?
It was that transformation because you get so much one-on-one attention, and she's seen so much, and she, you know, really mentored me for all of those years. And I thought to myself, I said, there can be no better school than this, because I just literally couldn't afford to go. And I just made the best, like I said, best of the opportunity that was given to me. So, you know, it's not about having that expensive product. It's about having the right products, one or two, it doesn't matter, but you can do a lot with that. And that's what I want to empower women with, that kind of information.
Yeah.
Because you don't have to feel overwhelmed. You don't have to look at somebody and be like, oh, she's only used expensive makeup. Or, you know, you have access to it. It is easy to get.
That's like a misconception that a lot of women have, that you have to buy a certain brand because it's expensive. It'll obviously do a better job, it'll give you better results, but that's not the case. And I think what you've showcased, even in the episodes, is that if you have the right techniques, you can do a good job regardless, right?
Of course. I mean, you just, like I said, it's about empowering yourself with the correct information. It's empowering yourself with the right tools. And it could be just one brush. It could be two. It could be one Kajal pencil. It could be, you know, it could be really like just what you need.
Mm-hmm.
But you can do a lot with that, you know. And I think that is the kind of artist that I, or that's the kind of artist I wanted to be when I came as part of this project. That's what I wanted to do. I wanted to, and we all actually wanted to,
yeah, of course,
empower women or whoever's watching, makeup enthusiasts, makeup artists, whoever, you know, that it's not about owning the best or owning everything. Eventually, yes, if you save your money, you will be able to buy that one fancy thing that you wanted. It happened to me as well. But also, you can do a lot with what is available to you.
Yeah, no,
and
definitely.
It doesn't have to be super expensive.
Okay, I want you to tell me, what are the top two things you love most about makeup?
That's an easy one. I love the creative process. I love the fact that it is a way to express yourself. There are no mistakes, because you can't, in a creative space, what I love is you can't satisfy everyone.
Mm-hmm.
And what you feel in what you create is the most important thing. So that is what actually really, really drew me, if you ask me, to makeup, because it gives me a space where I can just create with different textures and colors, and I can just be creative, and I can inspire everyone around me, and I inspire myself
to do the same, to be themselves.
Yeah, to just to be yourself, to be authentic to who you are creatively. Mm-hmm. You don't have to match up to anyone's standard. You don't have to, you know, you don't have to, you can create your own standard and just be creative and let that creative kind of, what they say, like let the creative juices flow.
Of course.
And then see what happens.
And then hopefully your makeup look will become iconic enough.
Yeah.
Your passion is so infectious. I love it. And that's why I knew that, you know, there's nobody better than you out there. And
I
Anjan's words ring in my head, and I have to say they are 100% true. And I've learned more from you in the past 2 weeks working with you and putting all this together than I've learned in 23 years of my existence, even with Instagram, Reels, YouTube, like all of that stuff.
That makes me so happy.
Okay, I want to ask you, and this is my final question for you, what is a message that you want everybody to leave with once they are done going through the lab?
The message that I want everyone to leave with, and hopefully I have done that, is don't be afraid of makeup. Experiment, take the chance, be creative, let the creativity in you come out. Have fun with it, and most importantly, you have to love the skin that you're in, because you are beautiful and you do not need to match up to anyone's standards.
And a little bit of technique can take you a very, very long way.
A little bit of technique, little bit of like the right tools and all of that, that'll come. But that's the message that I really want to send out to everyone.
I'm so excited for all of y'all to go through the makeup lab. It has been a real labor of love, but I genuinely believe that there's some timeless tips and tricks that you won't find anywhere else. So hopefully I will see you on the other side, and let your makeup connoisseur come out of you. If you want to take the next step, you can head up to the top of this page and hit buy now, and yeah, see you on the other side.